Let's pivot here, hard pivot to the president, President Trump, and an issue that is getting brought up more often about his mental health.
Yeah, specifically speaking, we're talking about when politicians or licensed mental health professionals talk about this on national news shows, newspapers, in the vein of suggesting that President Trump has mental illness, when none of them, not one of them, has met with the president in person to make that kind of assessment. So let's talk about why that might be a tad bit unethical.
You've seen the headlines questioning the president's mental health. Some cite his tweets, others talk about his tone, or what he said about North Korea, what he said about Charlottesville, or the falsehoods he has told. But does all of that make it legit for a former senator or a former intelligence director, or countless current mental health professionals, to talk about the president's mental health out in the open? That's up to you to decide. But first, let's talk about history on why this subject is really shaky ground for those medical professionals. Barry Goldwater, 1964, he ran for president and he had some controversial ideas. And because of those, Fact magazine did a survey asking people about Goldwater's mental health. That magazine then published the results with this headline saying, 1,189 psychiatrists say Goldwater is psychologically unfit to be president. Goldwater sued Fact magazine for libel. He won. Quickly thereafter, the American Psychiatric Association made it the rule of ethics for its members. Do not offer a professional opinion about someone in the public eye unless that doctor has conducted an exam of that specific person. Yes, the 37,000 psychiatrists in the APA should not be speaking about a public figure's mental health without having had a session with them. That seems pretty reasonable. And in addition to that, political scientist Larry Jacobs has this to say about people spouting off about the president's mental health on the political side.
Politically, it seems like, frankly, a nasty ripoff.
Why do you call it a ripoff? What do you mean by that?
Well, I think people who are trying to make a political point are ripping off the very serious issue of mental health.
He has a fair point. Mental illness is a disease that affects so many of us. It's not an issue to fight over. We have issues to fight over right now. The politics about the mental health of the president, well, there's something that can be done about that.
The 25th Amendment lays out a clear process for declaring a president unfit. And if a politician wants to try to invoke the 25th Amendment, they should go that route.
It would take some pretty sizable movement in the White House for that to happen, because it would require Vice President Pence and a majority of President Trump's cabinet to agree to get rid of President Trump. If he were not physically or mentally incapacitated, it would be like a modern-day coup. But back to mental health, and should it be fodder for experts to discuss? Like I told you, the APA says for its members, no. However, there is a group with a similar name, the American Psychoanalytic Association. It came out last month saying its members can talk about the president's mental health when talking about his speeches or his tweets, but it says it draws the line at diagnosing him.
2017, what a time to be alive. There are several mental health experts, professors in the mental health field of forensics who are writing books, who have written essays to newspapers, who have gone on these shows and do these things. Look, this is an ethics thing with the APA.
Right.
If they feel like violating that, then they feel like violating that. But it comes to a question of medical ethics if they are in the APA and if they signed that ethical code.
Well, and I think the even bigger issue is the talking so flippantly about mental health then diminishes the people who are suffering with mental health. So there's two different hurdles. I mean, two totally different topics there.
Totally.
But for people to say, oh, the president's crazy, or, you know, first of all, you shouldn't be using the word. And second of all, to just speak so flippantly about mental health does nothing to help people who are suffering.
Right. It's just as bad as when people say, oh, Kanye West is crazy.
Right.
Oh, Britney Spears is crazy, because you're reacting to something you see them do in the public eye. This is about a public figure. And if you want to talk about his tweets or his speeches, talk about that, but not about an individual's mental health. Just not
all right.
Fair.
All right.